Welcome back, everyone. So today I'm going to go through the 7 tools that I use just about every day, whether I pay for them, whether I don't pay for them, what I use them for, etc. But these are the 7 AI tools that I can't live without. I don't think you can either. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first tool in the list, and this is Canva. I use Canva every week to create my YouTube thumbnails. There we go. This is the thumbnail that you're watching today. And you see all of my other ones are in there. I use them for presentations. I use them to create logos, etc. Canva's a really fantastic piece of software. And I think since I've been using Canva, don't use PowerPoint anymore. I feel like I have tools at my fingertips to be able to create images and presentations, etc. Loads that you can do with Canva. I will put my video on Canva up here, right above me. So if you want to have a look at it, you can have a look in detail. But as I say, I think Canva, really fantastic piece of software. You can do loads with it. Saves me enormous amount of time and saves me money as well. Able to, as I say, put lots of documents together. Really fantastic piece of software, Canva. Definitely should be on your list. Okay, number 6 on the list is Claude. So Claude from Anthropic. So Anthropic have got a really strong relationship with Amazon. Amazon have just dropped a whole load of frontier tech models. Anthropic are involved with that. So I think Claude is something that we should certainly keep an eye on. Now, I use Claude, so I don't have a paid version of Claude. I have a paid version of Canva. I don't have a paid version of Claude, but I find that Claude is really useful, especially with creative writing. It's sort of, it just seems to do it a little bit better than ChatGPT, although I think actually ChatGPT has improved a bit. But Claude is a frontier large language model, a bit like ChatGPT. You can do a lot of the things that you do with ChatGPT, you can do with Claude. You can have, it's always had the sort of canvas functionality that I love so much in ChatGPT. It is really useful for, as I say, for creative writing. Yeah, there are a whole number of models available on Claude. You have projects on Claude. It's a bit similar to the projects on ChatGPT. So all in all, Claude's a really good large language model, and some people swear by it. That's all they use. I use it alongside ChatGPT. I don't have a paid plan, but I'm thinking about it. And I think I would like to have a paid plan so that I can use it in more of my automations. So that's number 6. That's Claude. Okay, number 5. Number 5 is MidJourney. Again, I'll put the video that I made on MidJourney up above. But MidJourney is just a piece of software that creates incredible images. And here I'll scroll through some of them. So these are all images created by MidJourney. You can just do some incredible things. Pink elephant in a room. You can just do some incredible things. Master Chief takes me back with MidJourney. I do have a paid account. I use it a lot. I use it a lot for creating books, etc. Let's just have a look. Oh, this was me trying to do a new background for my YouTube channel, playing around with some different images, playing with some colors here, trying to create a logo for a piece of work that we're doing at work called DigiSpin. Very cool. Always trying to do some better professor heads, make some nice pictures with cats to see if it was possible. I've seen some pictures of animals on Facebook and thought, are they real or are they AI generated? Well, clearly you can AI generate them, but still get some issues. See around here, some pictures not quite right. Always looking for bits of pictures to put in videos, etc. Anyway. And this was me trying to say sorry to somebody because I'd forgotten something and saying that I've got a head like a goldfish. And then thought, could I draw a picture of that? And so So I did. Anyway, that's MidJourney. Really, really cool piece of software. Something I use all the time, and certainly have a paid version of MidJourney. If you want to create incredible artwork, incredible pictures, MidJourney is the piece of software for you. Hope you enjoy. Okay, at number four, we have, am I going the right way around? At number four, we have NotebookLM. I don't have a paid version of NotebookLM, but you don't really need it. It's absolutely cool without it. So what NotebookLM is, and the video will be up there, that I did specifically about NotebookLM. But the really cool thing about NotebookLM is that you can sort of fill it full of your own documents, your own references. And what you do is you can pour them in up to 50. So it can be really, really significant in terms of how many documents you can put in. And then you can use the large language model to interrogate those documents, to create timelines, to create a study guide, to create a podcast. And that's its sort of party trick. NotebookLM, really good if you're doing research. And I use it regularly for that. Now, I haven't bought the plus version, but I might. I might. I'm having to manage how many of the things that I am signed up to, because it's costing me a fortune. But it's costing me quite a lot of money. So I don't currently have NotebookLM. I don't have Gemini either, or Claude. Those are three, they would be the top of my list of the next things I would want to purchase. Okay, number three. Now we're getting into the really hot stuff. So make.com. You've seen I've made a couple of videos on using Make. What it really does, it allows you to just create automations. And I think these are really, really cool. So creating automations, this one, I'll put the video up above. This one allows you to send an email to me. It then saves the email. It then downloads the email. It puts it up into ChatGPT. I had to create a vector storage for that so that you can put the information in. Then ChatGPT does some activity on it, downloads it, puts it into a blog format, creates a blog, then emails it back to the original sender. And Make is just super, super powerful. I think this is an area where we can where there is lots and lots that could be done. So here we've got an automation that automatically posts to Twitter, to LinkedIn, and creates a blog document. You could add Facebook onto that. Make is one of those bits of software. I do have a paid version of Make, although it's quite cheap. Make is one of those bits of software that really brings this technology to life and allows you to do some really cool things with the technology, drawing down from an API, creating bits of service that you can deliver. And bits of software like Make, there are other ones, Zapier is another one, but Make is the one that I've fallen in love with and use more than anything. This is about how you can really get this technology to help you in your everyday work life. And I think as we move into 2025, we're going to see much more of AI making a difference to your lives, rather than, I think, this sort of edge technology, these new frontier models. I think we'll still get those, but bits of software like Make are the things that really make the AI sing and make a real difference to what you do in your everyday life. So Make, absolutely fantastic, well worth it, well worth spending some time getting to understand Make. I'll do some more videos of it. If you've got a Make automation that you'd like me to look at, please put it in the comments below and I'll do it. I enjoy it, it's fun. That's Make. Okay, down to the top two. So number two on my list is Perplexity. Now, I'm relatively new to Perplexity. I've been using it a couple of months. I do have a paid account. I have a paid account a lot because I use it with my make automations. I really like the way Perplexity can summarize bits of activity. It can push out to the web, etc. It's effectively a super AI driven search engine. I've stopped using Google. I use Perplexity. I sometimes use ChatGPT search, but Perplexity is my go-to. I just really like the interface. And effectively, the difference, I guess, is that if you go onto Google, it gives you, and put a question in, it gives you a list of websites that you can search. If you go into Perplexity and put a question in, it'll give you an answer to those questions, and it will give you the website that it's got those answers from. So it sort of takes a step out. And often I'll be sat there and somebody asks a question, I can go into Perplexity, ask that question, get an answer almost immediately. Very, very cool. Makes me look smart in the room, which is always nice. And Perplexity, really good, really worth investing in my view. And it's cheap as chips as well. Perplexity is cheap compared to the other models that you've seen. I think it's about $3 a month. So Perplexity, absolutely my number two go-to piece of software that I use every single day. And it won't surprise you, here we are at number one, the piece of software I use more than any other piece of software, and it is, of course, ChatGPT. And ChatGPT has improved enormously over the year. We've obviously got new models. We've got O1, we've got the O1 Mini, GPT-4o is the sort of the go-to model that I use. There's also a GPT-4o Mini. I use that quite a lot when I'm doing a make automation. It's cheaper and quicker, we don't need, especially if I'm breaking down a task into smaller bites, you don't need the full power of 4o. I have done videos on various tools, so a video on DALL-E, I'll put that there, a video on Canvas, two videos on Canvas. I think I really enjoy the ability to basically either download a document or work together with ChatGPT on a document. Really, really powerful. I've done videos on O1, and we're told by OpenAI that we'll be getting O3. I'm not sure what's happened to O2. It's a good question. What's happened to O2? So I had a look. We've heard from OpenAI that they will be launching O3 at some stage in the new year, and I think we are getting extremely close to AGI now. And I know that I think that in 2025 we will have achieved AGI, and then we'll be getting into ASI sort of thinking. This technology is moving ahead incredibly quickly, and that's very exciting. But I mean, using ChatGPT as a tool where you can work on documents, I love the new project stuff. It keeps my chats all in one place. It means I can build up a body of knowledge. It means I can tell it how I want it to operate. I think projects is really good. I think Canvas was an incredible step forward. And although I've said it numerous times now, that while I think this the reimagining of the models and the new frontier model is super exciting and opens up the technology even more, I think actually what really matters are the interfaces. So things like projects, things like Canvas, NotebookLM, all of those, make.com, all of those are really just bits of software that help you use the large language models more effectively. That's where the biggest leaps have come for me. And that's why ChatGPT is my number one go-to. Every day I'm using ChatGPT. I do have a paid account, and I would keep that paid account. I've only got the $20 a month. I've not gone for the whole $200. I'm not a big enough user to need that. So the $20 a month does me absolutely fine. ChatGPT, if there is one thing you should go and have a play with in 2025 and you haven't already, ChatGPT is the way to go. Hope you found that useful. Let me know if I've missed out something. What is it that you're using that I'm not using? Do you think that I've got the rankings about right? Is ChatGPT really the top of the tree. It is for me, but I'd be really interested to know, you know, is Claude something that you use much more about? What should I be investing my hard-earned money in now? Put comments in down below. It'd be really great to start a conversation, find out what you're using, what you use it for, and what you think I should be using if I'm not using it already. I hope you've enjoyed that. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video, and I will see you soon. I've been the Professor. Bye-bye for now.